What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Darnell Smith, and welcome to Players Day Off, the show where we sit down with athletes and have a real authentic conversation about the careers on and off the field. Today, we got a real special edition episode. First of all, we're sitting with one of the best players in the game today, Raiders tight end, Darren Waller, and another guy. He goes by many names. Lil Tunchi, Lil Weezy. I call him the GOAT. But y'all might know the Lil Wayne, man. How y'all doing?
I'm just me, man. Dog.
Dog right here, huh?
Dog.
Dog.
What are you talking about?
Come on, man. Humble, ain't
come on, man.
He be balling.
Man.
He be balling, man. We're going to get straight to it, man. One question I always like to start the shows off with is, what was your welcome to the league moment, right? So for you, it'd be, Wayne, it'd be what was your welcome to the rap game? And what I mean by that is, think back early in your careers, right? Whether it was a play, a moment in practice, somebody you met who was a role model in your industry, where like you thought to yourself for a quick second, like, damn, I'm really here. Like, what was that moment for y'all? You must jump in first.
Yeah, I got hit by Dante Whitner.
Ooh,
49ers?
Yeah.
He's on the Cleveland Browns at the time.
Okay.
I'm running an over route on the play action, thinking I'm wide open. Catch it. He's like hanging over on the side of the zone and just like, ooh. He hit me in my chest and I got a concussion.
What?
So, and I was out to get, I crawled to like midfield and was like, I gotta get up. And then just went in, I was done for the day.
Shit.
Man.
It must have been that impact when you hit the ground. Ain't no way you can hit in the chest and get a concussion.
You got whiplash, bro.
Yeah. What about you, Wayne? What was your welcome to the league moment in the rap game?
We was on the tour, Hot Boys tour. And I tell the story a lot. And I got sick. This was back in the days where it was no such thing as your music was keyed up into a machine. Like, you know what I mean? There was no such thing as switching it. If you wanted to do something new, none of that. You got to do what was in there. So with that said, my solo songs was already keyed up in the sun. So we had to do the solo songs every night without me being there. So when they did that, Baby started noticing that whenever he said, man, every time I say Lil Wayne couldn't make it tonight, he was like, that turned the whole show all the way down to where it was like, we had to stop saying that and just having them wait, thinking you about to come out the whole night till we finally say, well, Lil Wayne was sick, he couldn't make it. So with that said, when I got better, I was ready to go back doing the routine. And he was like, nah, I got something new for you. And he was like, Lil Wayne couldn't make it tonight. And I'm sitting on the side like, yeah, I'm right here. And then they pushed me out there and said, nah, go out there.
He went crazy.
That was my time. That's when I knew that, oh, okay, I ain't not stand alone.
Right.
Yeah.
Damn, that's dope. Yeah. That's dope, man. One thing I want to talk about is just the similarity between music and sports, right? Like, for me, being an athlete my whole life, when I think about sports, I think about music. You know, before the games, I'm listening to music. During the game, after the game. And it seemed like, man, if you're a rapper, you want to play ball.
Exactly.
If you play ball, you want to be a rapper. So, like, that just talk about, I mean, what's some of the biggest comparisons or similarities that you guys see between the two?
I would say, you know, between a rapper, you know, when you go in the booth, you got your own persona. You got a vibe about you. When you step on the field, you know, we're, like, I'm masked, but there's a certain energy that I try to portray when I go out there on the field. Like,
right.
It's a nobody can guard me mentality. It's a, you know, nobody can stick with me mentality. So I feel like you got to carry that everywhere you go. It's a respect of other competitors and what they bring to the table. But at the end of the day, if you see yourself inferior to anybody else, you going about it all wrong.
Right.
And I see that with the rappers that I listen to and the athletes that I look up to. You take the field and it's like, ain't nobody seeing me.
You the best every time you step out on that field. How about you, Wayne?
It's pretty much the same. And also, I come from that era where when musically, as far as hip hop, we competed.
Right.
You know, we competed friendly. And there was no such thing. You know, you could diss a person, you could have the biggest diss song ever. And then 10 years from now, you and that person gonna probably do that same song on stage, his song about you and your song about them. But that was the era I came from. Not that it's not like that now, not that it's lost it, but it's not around so much. Yeah, it's a little different now. So I, like he said, I still approach every song with, you know, quote unquote, I'm the best rapper alive mentality. So I'm still competing with myself, if anything, you know what I mean? Cause I'm just as cool and humble with everybody out there doing what they do. And I respect everybody that do what they do.
Right.
But like he said, I'm approaching it with that supreme mentality as, you know, I love everything about it, but I'm a slaughter you.
How soon in your career did you really see like, okay, like this is a business?
Making such a dollar amount at such a young age, first of all, you know what I mean?
I can imagine that, first of all.
The check, the first check I bought my mom, I remember she was like, is this what we about to be doing? Yeah, it's just like, because we got to start changing some things if this is what we about to be doing. Right. So that, I mean, just plain and simple, that right there made it, fortunately, made it a long time for me to understand that it was a business. Because it made, you know, I started doing that at a very young age and bringing those type of checks home at a very young age, thinking it's gonna always be like this.
Right.
And the moment you realize it's a business is the moment it's not like that no more. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, and that day comes and that day came. Yeah, you just gotta make sure you get past that day and remember that day. Don't forget it. Right. Yeah, remember that day.
I realized it was a business when I got suspended for a year from the league you know, failing drug tests. You know, I was an addict, I guess. And, you know, just knowing that the team at that point was kind of just like, you know, we got to move past this dude at this point.
Right.
Because, like, I always thought I was going to get these extra chances time after time after time. And I come back from getting reinstated, and they drafted two people at my position. So I got cut, and I was on practice squad.
Right.
And just, you know what I'm saying, going from transitioning from making, like, six figures to when I was first guy out of rehab, I was working at Sprouts Farmers Market. I was getting paid $11 an hour. So it's like,
man,
realizing like, man, like, you ain't always going to be like that. Yeah. I got that taste of that. So now it's like, now I'm going forward, I approach it differently. But I'll say that time period, coming back, getting cut, being on practice squad, where it was like, man, them 2 years before, I was actually playing. I was out there.
Tell me if I'm wrong. Do you feel like coming up in today's industry, it's a little easier to be successful than it was when you was coming up?
No.
You don't? Okay.
Mm-mm. I believe it's equally the same.
Okay.
Given the times, just different barriers or whatever like that. My time, it was you had to be someone.
Yeah.
It had to be something about you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You had to be good. Plain and simple. You had to be good, or you had to be that terrible to where we just like you.
Right.
You know what I mean? So other than that, now, you know, I look at the difficulty in it now is because it's so many.
Right.
It's so many. How the hell are you gonna stand out? You know what I mean? And not only is it so many, is all of y'all sounding the same. All of y'all kind of going for the same thing. So it's hard to try to stand out within all that.
Right.
And if you know how to say, if you stand out within all that, well, you're doing something, man.
Nah, that's right.
That's why I said I couldn't imagine trying to be an artist, a new artist today I'm about to be the next Lil Who. And I'm about to, you know what I mean? So what about me? So cool to listen to me. If the next guy, is already saying the same thing, sounding the same, so it's like, it makes it more difficult to actually have something about you.
You've influenced a lot of artists, let's be real. A lot of artists, whether it's in their name, their style, we ain't got to get into no specifics, but a lot of people didn't kind of try to mock your style, and it's respect. I see it as a sign of respect.
Yeah, it's all love.
But then on the other side, it is.
When everybody was saying, you know, I'm a big influence, but I'd be hoping you just mean the look. And you know, the look and maybe the clothing or something, because I know I don't sound like that. So I'm afraid, I know you don't mean that one. I know
you're trying, though.
I know you ain't saying nah.
I feel like a lot of it is with the artists, they see what's going on right now, like what's popping right now, and they want to get with that instead of.
Oh, yeah.
Because staying with their own style may take a longer time for them to pop. Like, they may have to sit and wait. And be like, okay, like it's not popping right now, but you have to develop your craft.
And get in the door, and then finally, I got you.
They don't have that patience.
Nice. It's hard to have patience.
I had to do the same thing.
Yeah.
I had to do the same thing.
It's hard to happen. When you struggling, man, you ain't, you know what I mean? It's like, you want everything now.
Oh, yeah, ain't no patience today.
Damn. Especially, millennials, hey, I ain't gonna lie. That's our weakness, man. It's instant gratification.
We want everything right now.
Right now. I'm hungry now.
Rookie draft, number you throwing you right in the game. Right now.
Right. You ain't even on the bench for a couple years. What? Ain't no more Aaron Rodgers.
I was just telling somebody, I was like, he said for 3 years doing what? they didn't know what I meant. They literally didn't know what I meant when I said it.
Right.
Right.
They literally didn't know what I meant. I was like, you know, Aaron Rodgers said, like, for 3 years before he even got out there. I'm like, what are you doing? Sitting down doing what?
This ain't that.
Watch it. Put more.
Right. Your agency, man, Young Money. Just talk about that. Like, what inspired you to start that? Kind of walk us through that.
Love for sports. Plain and simple, love for sports, and also those who did it before me. Master P, Jay, obviously Jay, you know, Jay, just watching, and then watching Brian too, just plain and simple, noticing that, you know, you have a passion for it. It wasn't like it was going to do something that, you know, there was doing something that just because you got money and go do it. No, you have a passion for sports. You actually know what you're talking about. You actually love what you're talking about. You actually care. actually care about the players, you actually care about the game and whatever else, so do it. And so see what it do. You know what I mean? It was also an experience. I mean, I'm experiment first. We was like, let's just do it and see what happens.
Figure it out.
And it works.
So real quick, it's kind of a quick transition. So like I mentioned before, my man D. Waller, I don't know if you know Wayne, he make music as well.
Yeah, I know.
So, okay, all right, you already know. He dope too. I don't know if you got it. When you in that studio making a song, did you get that similar rush that you do when you scoring a touchdown on the field? Or what's that
feeling? Probably even greater.
I was about to say the same thing.
Probably even greater.
Really? Is it when the song's complete or just the whole process of it? Like,
nah, it could be nothing laid down.
It could be nothing.
The beat might not even be
good.
Just knowing, just that feeling.
Yeah, it's just a feeling. That's why I said when you asked about the touchdown, you know, of course, there's nothing, especially if it's a touchdown in the Superdome. In the Super Bowl, it's nothing more beautiful to win the game. But there's nothing more beautiful than your mind. Nothing.
That's a boy right there. You about to add that to it. You probably didn't say it before, but you didn't say it. Nothing more beautiful than your mind. Thing I want to talk about is your love for skateboarding.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me first of all, where that love come from?
I was watching a TV show. It's called Camp Woodward. It's like a little reality show, but about skating, whatever. They do a lot at Camp Woodward. Dude, Alex Midler was on it. He was a kid at the time, so I'm watching him every day. Now, something drew me to it.
Right.
Something drew me to, you know what I mean? I watch football every day. I watch basketball. I don't want to go outside. I ain't trying to go outside, you know what I mean?
Right.
Something drew me to the board, though, man. I was like, man, homie, like, he having a lot of fun. Look like, and then, you know, when you see something you think you could do.
Right, right.
Boy, you already know. I think I could do that. And then it's a world.
Really?
Yeah, it's not a thing they do, thing we do. It's not a thing we do. It's not something we do, like, you know, because we like to do. It's a lifestyle. Yeah, because once you put your 2 feet on that board and those wheels go, what I learned, the reason why I fell in love with it and stayed in love with it is what I learned is that no matter what I'm going through, no matter what you're dealing with, I don't care what you're dealing with. I mean, from debt to no matter what you're dealing with, once your 2 feet are on that board and them 4 wheels go, it's impossible to think about anything but what's in front of you. And after you do it for 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours straight, you know, what would I was mad about again? You know what I mean? So
that goes back to what you was talking about earlier. It sounds like skating for you, tell me if I'm wrong, is almost like meditation in a sense, right?
That's my breakthrough.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, we was talking about the same thing with getting tattoos earlier. It's like when that needle buzzing at you, it's like,
you can't think about nothing else but that.
You right there. you present.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm going to ask you this, man. Is it safe to say that Lil Wayne is the greatest hip-hop skateboarder of all time? Is that safe to say?
No.
Who messed with you in the hip-hop industry and in skateboarding?
Man.
Ain't no competition out there, Wayne.
I'm about to tell you, bro.
Talk to me, Wayne. Don't lie to me,
man. Bro, they got people that don't be wanting to show their skills for some reason. But when they get around me,
they want to show you that.
Man, I'm exposure, man. Man, first of all, Rich the Kid.
Rich the Kid get down like that on the skateboard?
Man, the man skate with 3 watches on, 7 bracelets, 5 rings. I'm out there with pads on.
Right, right. Hell yeah. Like anybody would think, right?
Man, the man got 9 chains on and doing 20 tricks I couldn't fathom doing. I've been skating for 10 years.
What? Rich the Kid.
That's just that, though. That's just
that. Oh, you ain't done.
We in my park one day shooting a video. I ain't gonna even tell you who come in there and fixed his own board.
Yeah.
When you know how to put your board together, you know how to skate.
It's different, right? It's
now, level. I could give you, you gonna put a board together for me? I could give you the slab of wood, the 4 wheels, the trucks, the man, came set that, put the board together. I made one for you too, Tim. It's for you. This one mine. I'm sitting there looking like, what you gonna do with yours though?
Right.
We about to use this in the videos or something for a shot.
Right, right, right.
Man, slime with the foom, heel, eye heel flipping. I'm like, you from Cali, that's why, right? You're like, you know, man, YG, man.
YG?
Man, YG, no, man. I'm serious, man.
YG skating.
Man, the hardest nigga in the world, man. I'm just sitting there looking like, man, this nigga blooded out. This nigga done turned to a whole kid in 5 minutes. That nigga was like, damn, this is a real skate park. That nigga put that bitch together and totally forgot we were shooting a video, man. Nigga with the jumping off and shit.
Bro, I would have never guessed YG, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
I was sitting there looking like, cause you from Cali. That's all I was like. You're like, yeah, you already know the homies growing up. I used to fuck with them every now and then.
Yeah.
Every now and then, nigga, you jump right back.
You put it together, right?
Yeah.
This is a lifestyle.
Yeah, so they got, you know how to do what they do.
Man, okay. Yeah. Well, I think you at least top three, top five hip hop. Yeah. We say that then.
Yeah, top five dead alive. I got that one. Right, yeah, right. Yeah, definitely.
Yes. So what about you, D-Wops? Obviously, we know you're into music, and that's probably your main thing, your main love next to football. Besides that, like, tell us something that the people don't know about. What's something that you like to do outside of just the music and football, man?
I'm a big meditator.
Mm.
I put a lot of time into that. It's just like the stillness of it, you know? The world is moving so fast. We got to grind and do this, do that. And we don't take a lot of time to just be still. I feel like when I take those times to be still, it translates into different moments where there's a lot of stuff trying to grab at my attention, but I can still be focused on what I'm trying to do. So that meditation, you know what I'm saying, morning and night, that translates into, you know, on the field, I could get hyped after one play, but then it's like, if I'm too hyped after that play, what am I going to do the rest of the game? What am I going to do play after play after play after that? So it's just, that's where meditation translates in for me. And it's honestly like that silence is the most beautiful thing you could ask for.
Man. Nah, that's something. Cause we always on go.
I've been considering it.
You always working one. You probably need to take a quick look.
I've been considering it, bro. I swear. I've been considering it. I looked out the window a few days and was like, quiet. You know, it's nice.
Man, you good? What up, Slam? Woo, you good? Back in the studio.
The soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Let's go ahead and wrap it up, man. I like to end the show off with something fun every time. I'm with my phone now real quick. So we're gonna do a quick little game, right? So what I'm gonna do is I got like a couple lines, some of your famous lines from some of your songs, right? I'm gonna say them, try not to rap them, just try to say them. And y'all got to guess which one of his songs it comes from.
I ain't going to know at all. I can tell
y'all might know. We going to see.
I don't know.
You know you don't know off the rip. All right. You might surprise yourself, man. All right, let's start off right here. Big house. Long hallways. Got 10 bathrooms.
Oh, that's,
I can sit all day.
That's with Gucci.
Come on. I ain't going to say nothing.
I still don't know the name of it. So. I know exactly. I'm about to tell you.
Stop playing weird. Come on, man. Oh, big house, and long hallways.
Got 10 bathrooms, I could shit all day.
Yeah.
What is that though? I don't know. You're singing it. Tell me what's that called.
Oh my God.
Talk to me.
Oh man, it got a cuss word in the title.
Five, four, three, two. We be steady mobbing,
man.
Come on, fuck. Y'all, you mean? You knew it, but you ain't know it.
You gotta catch me on tour. On tour, I know everything.
You know all of them?
Yeah, because I gotta practice.
Okay. This last one is fire. All right, here we go. Safe sex is great sex. Better wear latex, because you don't want that latex that I think I'm latex.
I don't know when I said it or why I said it or where I said it.
Wayne.
I said it,
though. Wayne, come on, Wall. Help me out, Wall. Safe sex is great sex.
Better
use a latex. Because you don't want that latex that I think I'm latex.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
And you ain't write that down, Wayne?
I don't write, man.
That just came in your head.
Yeah.
Lollipop, y'all.
I said it on Lollipop.
You said on Lollipop. Was it the remix?
I'm about to say it had to be the remix.
It might be the remix.
It had to be the remix.
Hold on, no, it's kind of
Lollipop. I know it's the remix because that's when I was going, when I do stuff like that, when I keep using the same word and keep playing with the same word, that's when I just know. I know it's one of them songs with Stunner or Mac and them Taz. Somebody just told me, go. We'll tell you when to stop.
Bro, when you said that line, bro, I'm like, this dude. Different.
And that's a great one too for bringing that up, cause that's rest in peace, Static Major, my man. R. Static R. Major, man. R. Yeah. R. So you ended that one off dope. You started that one off dope. You ended that shorty little stat. That's awesome.
That's all you gotta do, it, man. Hey, I appreciate you, Wayne, man. Nah, that thing was dope, man. Yes,
for real,
sir.
For real. I just want to say, man, I respect the hell out of you to see that you're doing what you're doing and still doing what you're doing for real. The way you do it, man. From day one, you had the same enthusiasm. You keep the same enthusiasm, and it's fucking contagious. For real, for real. Honestly, when you guys said, he was like, I like to end it with something fun.
Yeah.
Nigga, the whole shit was fun.
Nah, I appreciate it. I appreciate that. That means a lot, bro. I said, come for you, bro. Like I said, I mean, literally, this is my whole life, bro. Since I was six. It's a ride.